Hi, in this first of the two-part presentation, I'll be introducing you to the one and only powerful Spring Framework. By the end of this presentation, you should know what Spring is and the benefits it offers to our J2EE applications. Spring is a dependency injection mechanism that glues the various application classes across the J2EE tiers or layers together. For example, let's say we are developing a social networking website application that will replace Facebook. And let's say we are working on the update profile module, update user profile module. And here is our business layer class, which uses the data access layer class to update the user profile information. As you can see, the business layer class's update user profile method creates an instance of the DAO class, which does the database update for us, and then it calls the update profile on the DAO method. Now, instead of the business class handling this dependency creation, we can ask Spring to do this for us by simply declaring the user profile DAO at a class level, and we create a constructor which the business layer constructor, the business layer class constructor, which takes the DAO as the parameter. And we then provide Spring with the XML configuration file. And Spring at runtime will read this XML configuration file. It knows that the business layer class needs or depends on the DAO layer class to work. It creates an instance of the DAO class for us, and then it invokes the constructor of the business layer class by passing in the instance of the DAO. And now our update profile method on the business layer class can focus on the business logic instead of worrying about creating the services it requires, which in this case is the DAO class. Since Spring takes the control of creating the dependencies away from the application code, Spring is also called a IOC or inversion of control container. Before Spring, we used Java Naming and Directory Interface, JNDI, for dependency injection. JNDI requires our application classes to implement certain interfaces in order for those classes to be used in another layer. And also JNDI depends on the application servers like WebLogic or WebSphere. Spring, on the other hand, is lightweight, so your application classes need not implement or extend any fixed interfaces. And Spring works on POJOs, plain old Java objects. And Spring also doesn't depend on any application servers. So it is very easy to test your classes outside, unit test your classes outside an application container. Spring also offers setter injection. So instead of having a constructor on your business layer to initialize your DAO, you can have a setter method which Spring calls at runtime. And along with the XML configuration, you can also use, instead of the XML configuration, you can also use Spring annotations for wiring all your application classes together. To summarize, now you know that Spring is a dependency injection mechanism that glues your application classes together across the various J2EE layers. And Spring operates on POJOs, plain old Java objects, unlike JNDI, which depends on the application servers, and also JNDI requires your application classes to implement certain interfaces. Since Spring takes away the control of creating the objects from the application code, it's also called inversion of control container, and this mechanism is called inversion of control mechanism. Before I do the hands-on presentations where I'll be showing you how to configure Spring for your J2EE applications using XML configuration as well as annotations, in the next presentation, I will show you how Spring plays a key role across the various J2EE frameworks. Until then, keep sharing and learning. Thanks for watching.